After taking a few weeks off at the end of the year, I have walked away from it feeling very inspired, but also feeling like I just want to approach things very differently. And if you follow me on Instagram, I've talked about it briefly there. You might have also seen I completely wiped out my entire Instagram feed, over 3,800 posts, one by one, which took me a while. I completely archived and deleted everything and have just started fresh with the new year. And I am feeling very good about it, but I also just have a lot of thoughts about it in general. If you're interested, let me know and I will be happy to make an entire video all about that stuff and go into detail about it. But not everybody enjoys the whole sit down and rant kind of video, so before I like spend all of that time, let me know if you actually are interested in that, and if so, I'll make a video following up with that. But today, I figured I would make a video that I know people will click on, and that's a video about stuff and things. I've picked up a few things recently for my photography, for this YouTube channel, and really just for my own inspiration being in photo books. So today I'm going to go ahead and just share a few things that I've recently picked up that I've been really enjoying, and also things that you can expect moving forward on the channel. First up, the first camera is the Leica SL2S. I have been using the Leica SL2 since I think June. It's what's recording me right now, and I've been absolutely loving it for both photo and video. It's honestly the best hybrid camera I've ever used. I tried to go all in on a Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera setup strictly for YouTube. That way my SL2 would be freed up and I wouldn't have to use it for every video, because sometimes I want to make a video shooting photos with the SL2, but it's my one video camera. So I tried a Blackmagic setup, I rigged it out and had all these parts, and I just couldn't get myself to enjoy it and actually enjoy the quality as much as I've enjoyed the SL2. So I sold it and decided to pick up the SL2S, which was actually just announced maybe a week or two after I sold that Blackmagic setup. Leica was kind enough to kind of brief me on this camera before it was actually announced and told me all about it. And I immediately said, okay, put me down for a pre-order because I need this camera. This is essentially the SL2, but it has a 24 megapixel sensor as opposed to the 47 that's in the SL2. For photo, having that massive resolution is great in the SL2, but this lower resolution sensor, as well as being a backside illuminated CMOS sensor, it's actually going to have a lot of advantages for video specifically. Everything about the SL2 that I love, the battery life, the build quality, the menu system, everything is there. It's just a different sensor, but the low light with this camera is just absolutely insane. So there's definitely going to be a lot more videos about the SL2S since it's a new camera and there are a lot of questions about it. I've been talking with Leica about what we can do to kind of give people a lot more information on the camera from a practical standpoint. So basically, after this video, everything you're going to be seeing on the channel is more than likely going to be filmed with this. I can still film with the SL2 if I ever need to, but I really bought this specifically to be my main video camera for my YouTube channel as well as for clients. And also, as a result of that, you'll be seeing a lot more photos taken with the SL2 in future videos as well. I'm going to be using that for a project, and my goal is to kind of shoot the project with the SL2 and have Nathan kind of filming behind the scenes as I'm shooting for the project. So he'll be filming with this and I'll be shooting with that. I also sold my Leica M10P, considering I was also picking this up as well. It just seemed like a lot to just have. So as much as I enjoyed the M10P, I sold that to my good friend Chris Visser. It's going to be used all the time by him, which is great because I've really, really been enjoying using the SL2 for photo. And I don't need a Leica M10P just sitting around collecting dust. So next up, we have the South Trilogy by Mark Steinmetz. This is actually a collection of three books. You have South Central, Southeast, and Greater Atlanta. These books were reissued as a complete set by Nasraeli Press, and I pre-ordered them immediately as soon as I found out this was happening, because I've just completely fallen in love with Mark Steinmetz's work. This is an edition of 250, so they are are a pretty limited set. And honestly, I could not be happier with everything about these books. Not only just the work itself, but the way that the books have been printed. It's some of the best printing in any books that I have in my collection. I definitely want to do a full video just on Mark Steinmetz and kind of going through all the books of his that I have. But this collection right here is just incredible. And last but not least, the final thing was actually something that was gifted to me by my friends at Mint Camera. That is the SLR 670S. With the Mint Time Machine. If you don't know what this does, this basically attaches onto the top where you would mount a flash or any other accessories, and this is going to give you full manual control of your SX70. So on the shutter speed dial here, you have everything from auto 100 or auto 600, meaning I can throw SX70 or 600 speed film in this camera and set it appropriately, and it's still gonna choose my shutter speed for me if I don't feel like metering. But if I do want full manual control, I have everything from T or B for time or bulb for any long exposures, all the way up to 1/2000th of a second. Being able to manually focus through the lens is one of my favorite things about the SX70, because that alone gives you so much more control than most instant cameras out there. This just takes it to another level. I took it out and tested it on a hike a couple of days ago and just used the auto feature with 600 film, and so far the results have been great. So either the film were in two different batches, I bought them from Office Max here in town because it's the only place in Chillicothe that actually had 600 film in stock. I don't have any photo stores in Chillicothe, and Midwest Photo up in Columbus was out of stock, so I took what I could get, and half of the shots turned out really green and then the other half turned out really blue. I'm gonna be doing some experiments with this camera in a video very soon. I was actually hoping to do it today, but again, I've bought all of the film that's currently in town right now, but I have 20 packs coming directly from Polaroid that I ordered since they were restocked a couple days ago. So as soon as that film comes in, we're gonna film a video kind of experimenting a little bit with the temperature of the film, as well as how to meter properly, whether we want to meter for the highlights or the shadows, because I'm really just used to relying on the exposure compensation dial with the SX70, and I've gotten pretty familiar with different lighting scenarios and how to, you know, appropriately set that. But now, working with a handheld meter in different lighting conditions, I really want to figure out exactly how to get the most out of this film. So I'm really excited about that. Mint Camera, thank you guys so much. You will be seeing a lot more videos about this thing very soon. So those are just a few things I've recently picked up. Let me know what you guys think in the comments, as well as let me know if you want to see kind of just a long kind of open form discussion video about the time I took away, basically how that's kind of changed my views on social media and how I use it, as well as, you know, this YouTube channel. So yeah, let me know. Thank you guys for everything. I love you. I'll see you next time.